Hi everyone, this is Clemmy Games and welcome to the Indie Game Backlog. In this episode, we will take a look at Aliens Go Home Run, another breakout-inspired game which does something new by adding in bullet hell elements developed by Anim Ace and released on Steam in January 2017. For disclosure, I received this game for free. You play as Sally, a young girl with massive swinging power. One day, after hitting a home run, the ball actually flies into orbit and crashes into an alien planet, causing much destruction. Angered, the aliens then organize to invade Earth, and as Sally, you must then fend off said aliens. In the vein of previously covered games on this channel, such as Wizard or Death's Hangover, Aliens Go Home Run takes inspiration from the arcade classic, as the core game here involves clearing the screen of all blocks. While there is no narrative reason as to why blocks must be cleared, this game provided me with some fast-paced fun, which I thought played really well. The game does, however, do away with the concept of the pit at the bottom of the screen, opting for a system where the baseball is allowed to hit out of all surfaces including the ground. As a result, the constant need to dash to save the ball is limited. While this did make the game easier for me personally, the bullet hell elements introduced created more of a challenge. Here, aliens do spawn into the level, and at various intervals of time, will fire off projectiles in a variety of attack patterns. Fortunately, hitting the ball at the aliens will cause them to be temporarily stunned, and after a couple of hits, these aliens do get destroyed. Unfortunately, after a certain period of time, the aliens will respawn with no permanent way of getting rid of them, hence the challenge then falls down to clearing the blocks as quickly and as efficiently as you can. To cope with the bullet hell scenarios, Sally has the ability to slide, which allows her to temporarily absorb these projectiles and to take no damage. Also, instead of having a more ambiguous flat pedal to angle your shots off, she has a baseball bat with a definitive arrow, allowing you to aim and direct your shots. In terms of the difficulty of the game, I can say that this curve is a little inconsistent based on what I have played thus far. The earlier levels are a little too easy, and once you beat the first level set, it quickly ramps up. That aside, enemies were gradually introduced, with each having their own unique characteristics and attack patterns, resulting in a pretty fun and challenging experience. Also, the power-up system is interesting, in that while there are 4 power-ups available, these are dependent on additively collecting the power-up drops from the level. Here, starting from the first power-up on the left, we have an extra heart, allowing you to recover 1 point of damage, followed by the bubble, allowing you to take 1 point of damage without losing any health. The third icon is Multiball, which is self-explanatory, and finally, we have the Bat Wave, which gives you a limited number of shockwaves to fire off when you swing your bat. To unlock the Multiball, for example, you must collect 3 power-up drops in a row without using any, and upon using a power-up, this counter resets to 0, meaning that you will start at extra hearts again. Finally, I do like the art style and sound design in this game, which does certainly remind me of another age in gaming. Overall, I think that Aliens Go Home Run is a pretty good Arkanoid-inspired game. While removing the pit does change up the gameplay to its detriment in my opinion, the action, challenge, and levels are well designed and worth a look. Anyway, that will do it for this video. Thank you for watching. If you enjoyed it, please don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. Leave a comment if you like. Thanks again, and I will see you in the next video.